In this video, we're continuing on with the KutaSoftware free worksheet solving proportions under the geometry section. Picking up where we left off with number 9, our directions are to solve each proportion. This time, however, we're rounding our answer to the nearest hundredth. Same concept applies. We're going to cross multiply and then solve for the variable. So we're going to multiply 7.7 to B and 3.6 to 2.3. So 7.7 times B equals 3.6 times 2.3. So we have 7.7b and 3.6 times 2.3 equals 8.28. And when we divide by 7.7 in order to isolate that b, in other words, get the b all by itself, we'll get that b is equal to 1.075. However, we're rounding to the nearest hundredth. So this is going to be 1.08. And I know on the answer sheet it says 1.07. However, if we have 1.07, we're looking at the next number over to help us figure out which way to round. And if it's a 5, we're going to round up. So 1.08 is my solution in number 9. In number 10, when we cross multiply, we'll multiply V to 6.1, and that's going to be equal to 4.9 times 5.4. So 6.1V equals 4.9 times 5.4, which is 26.46. And when we divide both sides by 6.1, we'll get that V is equal to 4.337, but however, we're going to round up, so that's going to be 4.34, since that's our nearest hundredth. 4.34 is the solution in number 10. And again, on the answer key, it says 4.33, or 4 33/100. However, if we're rounding to the nearest hundredth, we're looking at the next place over, so that 7 rounds up, so this 3 will become a 4. In number 11, when we cross multiply, 6.3 times 9.3 equals x times 2.56. 6.3 times 9.3 is 58.59. And that's equal to 2.56x. So we're dividing both sides by 2.56 to get that x is equal to 22.886. And again, if we're rounding to the nearest hundredth, that will be 22.89. On the answer key, it says 22.88. However, they're not rounding to the nearest hundredth on that. They're just cutting off or truncating that thousandth value to get 22.88. However, since we're rounding up to 22.89. And lastly, for the set of directions, number 12. X gets multiplied to 2.17, and 3.4 gets multiplied to 7.7. 3.4 times 7.7 is 26.18. And that is equal to 2.17 times X. When I divide by 2.17, I get that X is equal to 12.064, and this 4 is less than 5, so it gets rounded down to 12.06. So 12.06 is the solution in number 12. For our next set of directions, we're going to solve each proportion, and we're going to leave our answer as a fraction in simplest form. So in number 13, we're cross multiplying. So 9 gets multiplied to 6, and 8 will get multiplied to k plus 6, this entire numerator. So we'll have 9 times 6 equals 8 times k plus 6. And what we're going to do is distribute that 8. 9 times 6 is 54, and that's equal to 8k plus 8 times 6, which is 48. Subtracting 48 from both sides in order to isolate the term with the k, or our term with our variable. So 8k will be left on the right-hand side of our equation, and 54 minus 48 is 6. So when I divide both sides by 8, I'll get that k is equal 6/8. However, 6 and 8 can be simplified. 2 can go into both 6 and 8. So if I divide each by 2, 6 divided by 2 is 3, and 8 divided by 2 is 4. So 3/4 is the simplest form of our fraction for the solution of our proportion in number 13. 3 times 2 is 6, 4 times 2 is 8. In number 14, 2 gets multiplied to a minus 3. So we'll have 2 times a minus 3, and that's equal to 10 times 4. Distributing the 2, 2 gets multiplied to a, and then 2 gets multiplied to 3 with subtraction in between the 2. So we'll have 2a minus 2 times 3, which is 6, equal to 40. I'll add 6 to both sides in order to isolate the term with our variable, the 2a. So I have 2a left on our left-hand side, and that's equal to 46. And when I divide by 2, I'll get that a is equal to 23, since 2 goes into 46 evenly. So 23 is our solution in number 14. In number 15, when I cross multiply, 10 will get multiplied to 3. That'll equal p plus 2, that quantity, times 4. So this time, I'm distributing the 4. 10 times 3 is 30, and that's equal to 4 times p, which is 4p, plus, since there's addition in between, 2 times 4, which is 8. When I subtract 8 from both sides, 30 minus 8 will give me 22. So 22 is equal to 4p. When I divide by 4, I'll get that 22/4 is equal to p. However, 2 can go into both of those evenly. 2 goes into 4 2 times, and 2 goes into 22 11 times. So 11/2 is my simplest form of our fraction in number 15. And lastly, in this video, I'll go over number 16. In number 16, I'm cross-multiplying again. 4 will get multiplied to x minus 1. The numerator of one fraction gets multiplied to the denominator of the other fraction. And that's going to be equal to the denominator that's left multiplied to the numerator, 6 times 8. In this case, I'm going to be distributing the 4. The 4 will get multiplied to x to equal 4x. There's subtraction in between those two terms. And then 4 gets multiplied to 1. That's equal to 6 times 8, which is 48. Adding 4 to both sides, I'll get that 4x equals 52. And when I divide by 4, I'll get that x is equal to a positive 13. So 13 is my final solution in this video. Join me in the next video where I'll finish out the worksheet completing numbers 17 through 25. Also, if you haven't already, go ahead and click that subscribe button and give me a thumbs up. Each like and subscription is greatly appreciated.